Loving Lord, what an honor it is to worship you. We worship you today for the gift of life. We bless your holy name, God, for lending us breath once again and for allowing us to see the light of day. Lord, we praise you for being the creator of this universe. We stand amazed, God, at the way you intricately designed nature and man so that everything we would ever need is already provided. God, we really have nothing to complain about today. We have sinned and come short of your glory, and for that we are experiencing sickness and death, financial and relationship issues, violence and crime, all sorts of painful situations, and we cause one another hurt. We have come to realize, Father God, that these are divine interruptions that you allow to teach us to just let go of all of our striving and humbly cast ourselves onto you who loves us and cares for us. And so, Father, amidst it all today, we just want to surrender it all to you and let you have your way in our lives. Each day comes with its own challenges, but we are prepared, dressed in the whole armor of God, to face what may come our way. You are with us, God, and we are grateful that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. So into your safe and loving hands, we present our bodies as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable unto you. May we have faith in you to forgive our shortcomings, heal our diseases, mend our broken hearts, set the captives free, and save us at last in your kingdom. Father God, we give you thanks for inclining your ears to us once again. Bless this ministry, every piece of equipment and service, our destiny workers, and every family member. Continue to provide finances to keep these wheels turning, God, as we continue the mission of spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ near and far. Amen. And amen. Today, family, for our scripture reading segment, we are going to read and digest a couple of verses on this subject that I have been guilty of. But by the grace of God, this is all being wiped away from my life. I will even be bold enough to say this morning that this has affected and or is affecting many of you as well. And so today, we want to further highlight this condition in an effort to eradicate it from our lives. Let's go to the scriptures, and you might want to get a pen and a paper. You might want to open an app on your phone or your tablet so that you can take down these scriptures. And at the end of these scriptures, we will talk about that subject. Amen? First scripture, Proverbs chapter 29, verse 23. A man's pride will bring him low, but a humble spirit will obtain honor. Proverbs 22, verse 4. The reward of humility and the fear of the Lord are riches, honor, and life. Proverbs 16, verse 19. It is better to be humble in spirit with the lowly than to divide the spoil with the proud. Proverbs 16, verse 18. Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before stumbling. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 12. Before destruction, the heart of man is haughty, but humility goes before honor. Proverbs 11, verse 2. When pride comes, then comes dishonor, but with the humble is wisdom. James chapter 4, verse 6. But he gives a greater grace. Therefore, it says, God is opposed to the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 33. The fear of the Lord is the instruction for wisdom, and before honor comes humility. Job chapter 40, verse 12. Look on everyone who is proud, and humble him, and tread down the wicked where they stand. Romans chapter 12, verse 16. Be of the same mind toward one another. Do not be haughty in mind, but associate with the lowly. Do not be wise in your own estimation. Philippians chapter 2, verse 3. Do nothing from selfishness or empty conceit, but with humility of mind, regard one another as more important than yourself. James chapter 1, verse 9. But the brother of humble circumstances is to glory in his high position. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 3. Do this then, my son, and deliver yourself. Since you have come into the hand of your neighbor, go, humble yourself, and importune your neighbor. And Proverbs chapter 14, verse 3. In the mouth of the foolish is a rod for his back, but the lips of the wise will protect them. Let me just go through those scriptures again. Thank you very much, Sonia and Dion, for memorializing them in the chat room. Just double check and make sure that you have all of them correctly. Proverbs chapter 29, verse 23. Proverbs chapter 22, verse 4. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 19. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 18. Proverbs chapter 18, verse 12. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 2. James chapter 4, verse 6. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 33. Job chapter 40, verse 12. Romans chapter 12, verse 16. Philippians chapter 2, verse 3. James chapter 1, verse 9. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 3. And Proverbs chapter 14, verse 3. What am I talking about, family? And I want to thank that website, Bible Knowing Jesus, for compiling these scriptures for us. What am I talking about? What are we talking about today? P-R-I-D-E versus H-U-M-I-L-I-T-Y. Pride versus humility. So just yesterday afternoon, I saw my sister Dion on a prayer line on Facebook. And one of the main prayer points was about pride and humility. This brought back a teaching I heard from one pastor recently, and also a word spoken into my spirit by another spiritual leader. This ZJoy VI, Joy Gospel Radio FM, was established by God for his purpose. And this condition, pride, can cause a lot of damage and even lead to its downfall if the enemy would have his way. But thanks be to God that this word stands true. His word stands true. And I, Angela Yolanda Burns, I am determined to go all the way with Jesus in spite of the obstacles. What God is doing and going to do in this ministry requires humility before God and oneness. I am learning to say I am sorry. I am learning to say I am sorry. And I am learning to walk away from trouble when I can. I am learning to bridle my tongue and not say the wrong things. Sometimes, God help me, I blurt out the wrong things. God help your daughter. The destiny workers that God has handpicked to be here must operate in unity. We must be in one accord. There is to be no competition, no jealousy, no siding with one person over the other, none feeling that we are better than or more high and mighty than the other person because we are more studied or have more connections or are even more approachable than the other. Here, each one reaches one and teaches one and encourages one and inspires one, all for the glory of God, not for the advancement of Angela or any one of our destiny workers or bishops or pastors or ministers or evangelists or elders. All for the glory of God. There is no place in my life, there is no place in this ministry that God has entrusted me with for the proud and deceitful heart. Help me, Jesus. There is no place for the proud and deceitful heart anywhere in God's kingdom here on earth. As in the world made new, that will not be allowed. We cannot pretend to be something we are not. I've always said from the onset of this ministry that I have to be careful of the doors I let open, the doors that I allow to be open. I've always said that I have to be careful. And notice I am saying we cannot pretend to be something we are not. We, please, I am saying we, because I know that somebody is going to be clicking the thumbs down button already. I know that somebody is watching this right now and casting aspersions and saying, I better live what I preach. And somebody is going to go away from here misinterpreting what I am saying. Nevertheless, by the grace of God, I forge ahead, knowing that this message has resonated in my spirit first and foremost. And by the mercies of God, me and my God are working some things out in me and for this ministry. This ministry is not mine. God will be glorified. Now, I don't know many of you personally, and I've deliberately stayed away from getting to know many of you personally, because there are so many isms and schisms and clans and cliques and all sorts of things that can form out of our humanness. All of us need to make sure that we have this deep relationship with God before we go on out and associate ourselves with people, because people can get the wrong impression, people can be misled, and we have to be so very careful. None of us is perfect. I'm going to get to that. Even though I don't know you, even though you really don't know me, you see me on the radio, but you don't know me. There's a saying colloquially that says, come live with me, come see me and come live with me, two different things. And we ought to make sure every day that the person that somebody else sees is the same person that they see when they actually live with them. But even though I don't know you, even though you don't know me, rest assured, God knows us. As we continue here at JGRFM, ZJoy VI, to speak against the wrongs in society, you hear them through the devotions, you hear them through the scripture reading, you hear them through the anointing of the Holy Spirit as I speak. There are some of us who continue to say, well, that doesn't apply to me. We are Christians. I'm a Seventh-day Adventist, or I'm a Pentecostal, or I'm an apostolic. I am a Catholic. You know, we call ourselves by all of these names. Oh, we love the Lord, you know, and we are praying to God. Yet, we are still living some bold-faced, sinful lives that even though people around us do not see, God sees. And you and I know exactly what we are doing. Are we really expecting God to answer our prayers for deliverance, for healing of our emotional distresses and physical ailments? Are we really expecting God to answer our prayers for financial blessing? We are deceiving ourselves. God is not mocked. God is a good God indeed, and he pours out blessings on the just and the unjust in the here and now. But what are we living for, if not to gain eternal life? The temporary pleasures of life are just that, family. temporary pleasures. See, the problem is we want to live how we want to live and not the way God wants us to live. We talk a good talk. We have proud and deceitful hearts. We don't want anyone to tell us anything or correct us as the Spirit of the Lord leads them to. And I know that I personally had a problem with that. You know, there was this person, as a matter of fact, a couple of people have told me in no uncertain terms that I was proud and, you know, I don't like to accept help and all of these things. You know, sometimes we believe we have it all together and we believe we don't need people. And who is this person anyway to correct us when they've got their own failures? No one is perfect, family. But God will continue to use each of us, imperfect human beings, to carry out his work here on earth. Once we are willing and available. And in carrying out this work, we ourselves will go through the process of purification. Amen? We continue to hear about the need to forgive as God has forgiven us. And we hear many people say, oh, I forgive him, I forgive her. Yet our actions continue to prove otherwise. Then there is also the situation where people genuinely forgive others for the wrongs against them, but the other person does not receive that forgiveness. In any event, each of us is being reminded today that unforgiveness will hinder our prayers and block out communication with God. If we say we forgive, and every time we see the person or every time we talk to the person who wronged us, our spirits get riled up, then I put it to you that we have not truly forgiven. I spoke to you the other day about this Facebook friend request that I received, and I put it in a corner there because I was like, you again? And you know, as I saw the person, it just brought up some stuff that we went through. I accepted the person finally yesterday, and I'm like, God has given me so many chances. Who am I to cast this person aside? This person has been an integral part of my life. And I'm like, God, you know why you allowed that person to be in my life. Who am I to shun that person? All right, hands up. I accepted the Facebook friend's request. Some of us, family, need a heart transplant that only God can give. If we say we forgive and every time we see that person, every time we talk to that person who wronged us, our spirits get riled up. I put it to you that we have not truly forgiven. In that case, Angela, in that case, family, we need a heart transplant that only God can give. May God help us all today. Pride must die. Self must be slain. Flesh must be killed. And Christ must live in me. Christ must live in you. We must come in alignment with the plans that God has for our families, for our lives. As we approach that day when Jesus Christ will return and make all things new. It is urgent, family. When we die, we don't have a chance. And does any one of us know whether we're going to live the next minute? May we hear this word today as from the Spirit of the Lord and not from this mere mortal. I am struggling like you, but we are already victorious through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.